starting to wonder how this world would be. Bila wewe, na kama singe bata mtoto mzuri kama wewe. Nina come back only to check you, wewe. Kwani, I will repeat myself bila wewe. Nina look forward to the future na wewe. Growing older and happy na wewe. Ndiyo mana nina taka to make it up na wewe. For all the hell I've gone through, me na wewe. Honey, I'm so sorry, nina promise wewe. Na hii, haitakuwa rough tena na wewe. Unanipenda na kupenda pia wewe. Kama chanda na pete, I love you forever and ever na kama hot bitch. Life bila we ni kama kuma bila bitch. Na kwenye cold weather baby we in my hands. On top of my game honey, will inspire to get more hits. Ndiyo mana life yangu ilikuwa complete. Lakini sasa stress ina ni it. Nili lose everything kwa sababu nili fight. Single seed in the calabash, loneliness in the bites. So please tafadhali nipe last chance to make it right. I'm tired of the dark side, so please nip light. Na just come up on your script, na play right. Life yangu na we, ilikuwa all is right. Na bila piracy, only copyright. Nina over one chance, one night to recite, ignite and hold you tight. Mapenzi ni safari, when in my mash cool, my number one gari, na mo fire bonfires, it a nari, bakali that I can only afford kuliko Ferrari, tadabal nomon salakan, umon bitimnita, shari, kalam tomon milan, umon bibari, ita ya time of me, ana yataki mahari, Mapenzi, I'm sorry. Ita, yeah, my only story. For the hard times na my good times, when in my glory, yeah. Moyoni rohoni, sita worry. Slowly by surely, sita hurry. Mpenzi, mateng teng, I am so, so, so sorry, yeah. Siwezi yani, siwezi yani ku let go. So please tafadhali look into my eyes and say I love you so. Nakupenda ma, and I am sorry.
What a line, what an emotional piece from Ugly Emcee, Last Chance, Old It Be by the First Chance on the Underground, just in case you're joining us, right? We do it big. Yeah, that is
actually really surprising. Yeah. Our signature is
Oh yeah, yeah, sorry. So
really surprised that our signature is actually a laughter.
Easy on this. Underground maziko live yani kwa watu wote wanatusikiza.
Kwani mbona kila mtu anashangaa hii story?
Man. I don't know about
this. These kids wanashangaa sana kwa
hii. These kids, what's up?
Ni mtu 19 ama ni mtu 80?
I don't know what she'll tell us. She's listening.
Okay, so sorry.
So, we do it live and raw. Bring you those undercuts and uncut sweet anthems of things you never ever listen to on radio anywhere else, man. It has to be on the underground. And talking about those MCs that you'll never ever hear anyone else, not even in the middle of the pages, because it is a Friday or Saturday, unajua. We're talking about Ugly Emcee,
Actually, General Ugly Emcee.
Yes, General Ugly Emcee. I don't know. Yeah, yeah. Is this a name or just a title?
No, it's not just a title. It's actually a name. General Ugly Emcee. Or maybe you'd say Generali Ugly Emcee.
Generali Ugly Emcee.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I think sometime back at about 9 or so, we actually propped and said, we'll be having Ugly Emcee in the studio.
Yeah.
So for those that didn't hear anything about you earlier, Okumu asked you one question.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Why ugly?
Mm-hmm. Well, my name is...
Super ugly.
My other real name is Abbas Hassan Muhammad. Mm-hmm. Ibrahim, I mean, aka Abbas Chuchu, aka Abbas Mende, aka Abbas Mambo Mingi, aka Kasuku, because I speak so much. But then, most significantly, aka General Ugly Emcee. And why ugly? You know, ugly is basically a true definition of self-esteem. You know, the love that I had for myself, for what I represent, for my fire, you know, like who I am, my identity, you know, definitely had to make me ugly. And that was actually way back when I went back to my country. That was in 1998, when I was in exile. I was in exile in this country, you know, in Kenya, for more than a decade. And it was pain, because most time I really wanted to go back home. But when I reached home, guys, it was another story. So that reflection, the surrounding, you know, the stories, everything around me was very ugly. So I became ugly.
Okay, anyway, we'll be getting to that depth. Okumu, what do you think?
Definitely, when we come back, right? Yeah.
No, but I think before we go far, you know, Uganda has its Independence Day, which will be,
tomorrow,
I think,
yeah.
tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
So we want to, when we come back, we'll be talking about it and what really it means to you as a hip-hop MC.
Yeah.
And what it means to for East Africans and independence and so on. What do you think, Okumu?
When we come back.
You're repeating that line all the time. What is it?
Alright. And this is Bonfire Anthem by General Ugly Emcee. And he is live in the studio.
Bonfire.
This is the Underground on KBC English Service.
Call me the inspector. My haters wish I graduate to my spectators. 11 feet and then I'm was it gonna when you hear funny he game. Give me body lickana. Ni more fire, bonfire. Kill an apple pitana. My swag is on, yes. Kill a kid to yes, yes. Oh, yes. See utani manzei, kwani, kwenye mizani hawatoshi. Stories all baboon, katundi yomani. Medigana, get up to get them zayani. Mebuka board and a coast to coast. Ninetapa kamzaya, nisaya kazi. Put your hands up, nisaya kazi mzaya. Ni more fire, we.
Ni more fire, yes. Ni bonfire, yes. Ugly, yes. Get up together, yes. Ni more fire, yes. Ni bonfire, yes. Ugly, yes. Get up together, yes. Ni more fire, yes. Ni bonfire, yes.
Gijibana gigata tajifatana gisidu kasmataki batali sentaki afin kalam afinata dunia takija deiga itabidu sita wen itabijada wen sibuei wei gen falata urudu jagal kalam gelebeta kalam afinata kanita gifata kasmataki jagal itaya ita talabada sade wede ya wakti abas tutu ugly Emcee. Tina dom nubi, muru futu combo, hilu futu sucker, rust gold jala didi. Yeah, rust gold jala didi. More fire way.
Ni more fire, yes. Ni bonfire, yes. Ugly, yes. Get up together, yes. Ni more fire, yes. Ni bonfire, yes.
Na my unwanted titles. Na kama hawanya weni my subtitles. Ghetto storyteller. What's a lie? What do you know about life of the ghetto MC? Walima Liza wala shame and the game is still going on and on. Competition ain't it. My fake MCs kama hao bilampango. Na mystery bilavina. What a woman daddy. Styles are good deadly.
deadlyani. Come up, yeah, Giuliani. I'm the king, the lord of the underground, and so dangerous on the podium. Come up, petroleum. Me eat a generali, the field marshal. Come up, my late grandfather, striking hard like thunder. Underground to the mainstream, I'm focused, taking the game and say to another level. Yeah, another level.
Me more fire, yes. Me bone fire, yes.
All records, Uganda National Theater, Bonfire Uganda. Ini onyo kwa mafek MCs na masnitch. We running Kampala City, making real hip hop beyond the bets. Bonfire, more fire, bonfire, more fire.
Yeah, bonfire, more fire.
More fire, yes.
Bonfire, more fire.
More fire.
Yeah, and that's sad. Ugly,
yeah, General Ugly. And you know what?
General Ugly.
The other day when yesterday, no sooner had I alighted from my bus, than a friend of mine was like, "More fire, mash poor, mash cool, more fire." I was like, "What, Sadie? Yeah, we're waiting for you tonight."
Oh, so we're live here. So this is a slaughterhouse, right?
Yeah, this is a slaughterhouse, man. Guys are like, "We are waiting for you."
Oh, yeah, man. So shout out to all the people.
Yeah,
traveling in Mashkul.
Yeah, Mashkul. Actually, Mashkul. Actually, you remember in the last song, last chat, there is a verse that I was trying to convince this beautiful lady that I loved so much.
Yeah.
And, you know, she was like, "I don't want you anymore, Ugly."
Mm-hmm.
In the last verse, where I was saying, "Na kama penzi ni safari, when in my Mashkul, my number one gari na mofire, bonfire."
Hey, you see, man,
it's in the blood.
Yeah, man.
And also, actually, thanks to Mashkul, Mashpoa. Thanks to my biggest fan ever, by Yusufu, Brother Johnny, you know, Mzee Ali, you know, everyone. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been here. Because they're like, "Man, we have to push this thing. You can do it. You can make it."
Yeah, actually, you're talking about this guy. How do you know them?
Well, we work together. Actually, I work with Mashkul and Mashpoa.
Mm.
I part time with them. That's every evening and every early in the morning.
Yeah.
Actually, they taught me to wake up early. So by 3 a.m., I'm awake. 4 a.m., I'm awake.
Mm.
I have to catch the bus and help them, give a hand, you know, one way or the other, and also meet a couple of my fans and my friends.
Yes.
And then move to Kampala, you know, after the first, second, and possibly the third bus. And then later in the evening, the same thing again. So Mashkul, Mashpoa has really helped me so much to bridge the gap.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So here we're talking about, we're talking to actually General Ugly Emcee,
yes,
right?
Yes.
A son who's one of the rider lines, so those lines that you mentioned before someone, and he's like, "Okay, who am I talking to?" You know, you're like, "Yeah, I'm generally Ugly Emcee."
Not military. Not a military general.
But
an artistic general.
Yes, and you are a grandson to...
Yeah, one of the grandchildren of the late Field Marshal, His Excellency Al Haji, conqueror of the British Empire, Idi Amin Dada. But to me,
who died when?
No, his name is not dead. To me, he's still alive. His spirit still lives in me because his blood flows in my veins. You know.
And now,
from his reflection, you know, in Africa, our ancestors, our people never die. That's what you see. You are named after. You are maybe your uncle who passed on, so his spirit passes on to you. Sometimes I sit down and I look at myself, I'm like, am I my grandfather, or am I this and that? So I really feel like my grandfather is still very, very alive.
Mm-hmm. And how was it growing up in more than four countries?
It was not easy. Actually, one other thing that I would like to tell you guys is, and also to our dear listeners, being a refugee is a very painful thing because you always long to go back home. But the unfortunate part of it is that when you long to go back home, when you reach home, you find the whole ground is not leveled for you properly. You know, like actually for me, it was the worst ground. 1998 was not easy. Most times I would tell mom, you know what, I would like to go back home. I would like to go back home in Nairobi and maybe perhaps study from there. And she was like, "No, this is your country. You have to be here."
And to me, today, actually, I can say I really feel so comfortable in Uganda, because the all the stereotypes, the negative stereotype, had to like go away. Now they are not only just seeing ugly as ugly, but they're saying ugly as a general. MC ugly, like inspiring young people. Mm. And through Bonfire, I've significantly actually changed so many things.
Okay, I mean, when you say your story, actually, it's yes. A little bit painful, because I think at the moment my mind goes to maybe people from Sudan, yeah. South Sudan, and people from Somalia, yeah. as you're talking about refugees. But let me connect the two.
Mm.
Was art a way of healing, or was it a way of running away from the challenges that you had?
I would say both, because actually, first of all, it was a healing process for me, because way back, actually, when I was still in primary school, even in kindergarten, you know, I loved music so much. And so through, when you reflect and listen to most of my music, most of my songs, I'm actually talking about my story. Actually, my first album was, I named it Story of Maisha, Story of My Life. So this was all a reflection of each and everything. So it was more of a healing process. Mm-hmm. And also, when I would look at other issues that are involved in my community or being an artist, I was like, if this is what I'm going through, then how about other people, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And today, as we speak, I work in my country. I work with InterAid Uganda, mm-hmm. UNHCR, American Refugee Council, and a couple of other refugee organizations, which are also into the healing process of refugees and integrating them into the Ugandan community. So you find that is what I'm pushing. But sometimes guys are like, but General, why are you so much into this? Because honestly speaking, this is me. I wouldn't want my country to go back to war. I wouldn't want Kenya to go back to go back into any
2007,
1982. We need to live at peace with each other, you know, because peace is very important. Where there is peace, you'll get everything that you want.
Let me throw in the question that we mentioned earlier. We said we'll be talking about Uganda's Independence Day.
Yes.
What does it mean to you, and what does it mean to Africa when we talk about just independence? Is it just about the flag?
Well, I would say no, it's not just about the flag. Actually, when you talk about independence, we should look at it as, you know, when the colonialists came to our countries, to our land, they took away our freedom, they took away our expressions. And now, to me as a hip-hop artist, you know, there's a slogan that I really stand on and say as a hip-hop artist, that hip-hop is bigger than the government, hip-hop is bigger than the regime, because, you know, it's only through hip-hop that you can really freely express yourself. Mm. Actually, in my next album, this very album that I'm working on, called Grandson of a Dictator, mm-hmm. my next album, mm-hmm. there is a song I'm working on, and this song is called Hisia ya Change, Attention to Change. And in this song, I'm actually digging deep into issues of independence, issues of freedom, issues of liberation, and also by the same time reflecting in the 70s when my grandfather was still president of my dear country.
Mm.
So talking about, are we really independent? Sometimes I feel like we are still not really independent, because in Africa, for us to be really, really independent, we need to have leaders who are so passionate, and leaders who love their country. That's the problem that we're having. Actually, when you come back to my country, our country is still not moving in a proper sense, like the way it's supposed to be. Find most of the things are disintegrated. So this ninth independence, there's so many things actually we were asking ourselves as young people. We were like, what is the government has been putting in so many things, my government, things to do with the youth fund, things to do with the youth welfare, and these things are not moving. But then now it comes back actually to now me as an artist, as an activist. There is one big thing that we are actually advocating for and signing our petition. And let's hope that this time, to all our dear listeners and mostly my Ugandan brothers and sisters, let's all join our hands together. In this Independence Day, we should know that our national theater has to be an independent ground for us as artists to create our art, because it's our heritage to express ourselves. So the national theater should not be for sale if you're really independent.
Oh, so are you saying that someone is trying to sell it? It's just beside the Uganda Broadcasting Corporation, eh?
Yeah. So you find somebody wants to take it over. So you ask yourself, somebody's going to privately own the National Theatre, wants to take it and build skyscrapers, then after 30 years it gives it back to us. So what will happen in between the 30 years? You know, when somebody owns a national heritage, you can do anything with it.
Okay, listeners, so, if you're joining us this moment, today we're talking to General Ugly Emcee, all the way from Uganda.
Yeah, from Uganda. Actually, from the source of the Nile. I live at the source of the Nile.
That is Jinja.
Jinja, yeah. Stone City.
Okay, you can call us on 0725-281-428 or 0736-538-431. Find us on Twitter. Our handle is The Underground KE. Now that's DA Underground KE. Find us on Facebook. Our fan page is The Underground KE. Okumu, which song are we listening to?
I like Generali Mwenyewe. Yeah. You introduced this. It's called Bimian Lubi.
Well, honestly speaking, there is a friend of mine, and actually, he's actually now going back to Kampala. He's called Arua. Mm-hmm. Honestly speaking, he's one guy that, when I first met him, he's this guy who is always happy. You know, I've never seen Arua when he's pissed off. He loves his job, he's so passionate, and he's a very good friend of mine. Not only my friend alone, and actually, my other friend, my biggest fan, that is Bayusufu, who is actually driving now back to Kampala. Mm-hmm. And this is what he told me. So, I mean, you know what? Arua mi kila nikimcheki manze na tikiwa mtu akona kazi sana. Unadhani vipi das? Kamambia hui tamani mpoa. Mi jamana mfini. Nile jamaa, yani kila sana changamka. Actually, this song is dedicated to Arua. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking at the video. I'm actually looking. When I was writing this song, I was looking at Arua. Because, you know, Arua is one guy who... who loves beautiful women.
Oh,
and this and the
you're defining the song. Yeah.
And the Bini Anubi is a beautiful woman. Actually, one thing that what you guys should know.
Mm-hmm.
Nubian women. So this song is 100% Nubi. Uh-huh. So actually, in the bus, whenever we'd be traveling, you'd find when I would be speaking with Arua and then Mzee Ali, and of course, we are just speaking Nubi. And then Bayusuf would be like, you guys, you want to send me a word? I'm like, no, I want you to learn this language. Because when you learn this language, this, you know, being a Nubian is being very, very African.
Okay, I think when we come back, we'll be talking about the Nubian language a bit and this song.
So being a Nubi, more fire, yes.
Haba he lose sight for to lasen. Tanarede, he lose sight for to suka.
Yeah.
Kila kan anafekir for only one moment. Gal wede began lobu my last breath. Ana bikele mate. Ja ana agi jazait my girl, but my don't tie. My nafsi my good reptai cool. Yes. Ukila kan anafekir ja wede began my last moment. I infest. Lon taki, asas taki. Ana bidugita. Pizza getir my kam. Than shade through Facebook or WhatsApp time. Ukila kan ana fakel ja where they began the last time. Abu ana be bonus mate, be asthma, is taki. Ana be fakta adanta ifadaya kede ana asthma, is taki ya hilusai. Yeah, ukila kan ana fakel where they began maratai. Tamui shota asthma gel bataki jagi. Dugu dugu. Ana bishukuru Allahu maulana fidhibita finafsi. Life yani maisha tai. Ukila kan ana feket. Wede ya mara taita mwisho to feel the touch of your skin. Yani hilu tagildu taki. Ana bijuri tagerima ana then embrace and hug you so tight. Bini ya nubi ana ajita. Yeah, more fire, yes. Bini ya nubi dugana ma ting ting. Bini ya nubi tai duga na ma ting ting. Bini ya nubi tai duga na ma ting ting. Bini ya nubi tai duga na ma ting ting. Anagi num lakin gel batai fifadi. Anagi asma mahaba taki dukubab.
Fatana na lindi. Fatana na jinti mahaba lafta.
Wogi kelem bises bises. Ana groom for my love captain. Ana fatano hagen. Uwokum ana fidusto. Mafuraha keten min gel bato. Walai ana kan arfu mafuraha yasunu. Telling ya ni dreams will someday come true. Ukan anagi amin kalamta mahaba ma. Not until I met you. And now you're here. Ukana arfu. Ita ya malaika ma angel from above. I promise to stay with you forever and ever.
mini ya du du gana ma ting ting
yo wele du bitai du gana ma ling
ling mini ya du bitai du gana ma ting ting
yo wele du bitai du gana ma ling
ling mini ya du bitai du gana ma ting ting
yo wele du bitai du gana ma ling
ling du gana ma ting ting
yo wele du bitai du gana ma ling ling
boss chuchu aka General Ugly Emcee. Your best MC, then I don't know if Ross Gold or Ladidi, my bin to piss. No more fire, yes.
Gina Dom, what's the name of the leg? Abu Mabana, when they talk for my jama. Don't take a while in the pool of Nubi. Mata jada ball, mata jada ball. Rudu ite nubi salakan fit. Wesi mabatal rudu ite nubi mata ain higher. Mata ain batal. Rudu ite nubi jada ball, jada ball. Salakan umon ain ite batal. Rudu ite nubi ina kulu wai. Dom teina nubi, tan teina nubi. Mila teina nubi, destru teina nubi. Kila soko teina ulu nubi. Rockab Tina, Hilu Norman, Labasa Mabana Tina, Asas Norman, Adamada Sultana, West Norman, Bahma Maguta Tina, Futu Tormon, Fus today, Mudu Itanubi, Anime Tanubi, Itamana Kuluai, Jinna Dom, Mata Jada Bal Mata, Jada Bal, Mata Jada Bal Mata, Jada Bal, Mon Fain, Mon Fain, Mata Jada Bal, Mudu Itanubi, yeah, Mon Fain, Mon Fain, Mata Abana, don't say the why. Don't say the why. Umon fade, umon fade, mata jada bar, rudu in a nubi. Yeah, umon fade, mata abana. Don't say the why. Don't say the why. Yeah. Kan dom tegilizait futu moyo kan lasen hiluzait futu sukar kan lomun kemirizait futu arday kan mutu giwajazait futu ayan kan mahaba hiluzait futu lasen dead falata asanita sual asanita sual why le ita maana yilimbadum yo mutu joju machai barwa le wazema wele abugo mabana wafaka tomon fi si ya zaidi le ina ginigi tu kidima gali ina huri ujebatena ya fifu zaidi le mila mada sultana gisofu yuwadu kila sa kila yom le wele mabana tena abagaraya galiki inafa umon ma inafa umon ma le ina kanfi fibambara sana tisa lakin istaina vudretaina sade ma le ina girudu ma gali ina nubi milantaina gali umon bari murumu nduku ku kakwa aluru sita kumgesa sita kumgesa ina kulu wai ina kulu nubi ina kulu wai ina kulu nubi yeah. Umon fain, umon fain, mata jada bal, rudu ina nubi. Yeah, umon fain, mata abana, don't say the why. Don't say the why. Umon fain, mata jada bal, rudu ina nubi. Yeah, umon fain, mata abana, don't say the why. Don't say the why. Yeah, listen, ana binaga, listen up, bifata. Aina na batal, kwenu sana batal. Listen, ana bifata, listen up, bifaga. Salakan haki kiwaja futu ebin. Listen up, bifaga. Salakan itakum abana. Gayana, listen, ana bifata. Ya ana jina dom, jina dom. Makroboni ana amsuku. Ana kiwakilisha mimbombo koboko. Kibirwa, jinja, arua, aliwarwa. Naguru mabakan kulu. I'm in a fear, fear. Ina yanobi mata abana. Ina yanobi mata sibana. Ina yanobi mata abana. Ina yanobi mata sibana. Edena limbadum, aon badum. Ina kulu wai, ina kulu nubi. Umon fain mata jada bal, rudu ina nubi. Yeah, umon fain mata abana. Don't say the why. Don't say the why. Umon fain mata jada bal, rudu ina nubi. Yeah, umon fain mata abana. Don't say the why. Don't say the why. Umon fain mata jada bal, rudu ina nubi. Yeah, umon fain mata abana. Don't say the why. Don't say the why. Umon fain mata jada bal, rudu ina nubi. Yeah, umon fain mata abana. Don't say the why. Don't say the why. Yeah.
And that's Inanobi playing on the underground, the KB single service, the tune. And before that, yeah, General Emcee Ugly.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, Inanobi means we are Nubians.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, with this song, I'm actually advocating for the different sets in the Nubian community to mm-hmm. all come together and acknowledge and accept that they are Nubians.
Mm-hmm.
The Kuku, the Bari, the Mundu, the Alurus, you know, all the different sets to unite. Mm-hmm. You know, because, you know, you might ask yourself, you might think that Nubians are just from Kibera number 9, like here in Kenya. Mm-hmm. But no, no, man. Nubians are all over, man. And actually, when you look at the origin of the Nubians in Africa, Nubians are around Nuba Mountain, Egypt, and it was one of the biggest kingdoms ever. When you look at the history of Queen Sheba, the history of the Nubians conquering as far as parts of Europe and all that. So Nubians, being a Nubian is being very, very African and being very, very strong. And actually, when you listen, did you listen to the first verse here? For the song where I was saying mata jadabal mata jadabal rudu itanubi sala kan fikuwesi mabatal rudu itanubi mata anhaya rudu itanubi don't tain a why. Basically here I'm actually telling you, man, you have to accept you're Nubian for this,
okay.
You're
a Nubian.
Okay. I'm a Nubian, yes.
Okay, something that I find interesting in this song is like, this is the second song. We'll talk about the first song later, but let's talk about this one here, where you are purely talking about people being proud as Nubians.
Yes.
You're saying, let them come together, which is a positive thing. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yes.
Just take me back a little bit. Mm. What is this Nubian language? Because Nubians are all over. They're in Kenya. They're all over. They have spread all over. What really influences the Nubian language? I feel as if it's Arabic.
The spread of the Nubians.
Yeah.
Well, Nubians spreading out. You know, our history, Nubians have always been, you know, we are so military. Like, so when the British came to Africa, the tribe that they saw that they would really work with was the Nubian tribes. Because the Nubians were naturally warriors.
Mm.
So they had to get them. And wherever you know that the British did rule, they are Nubians.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever they colonize, that's how you Nubians come to Kenya. Nubians are in Tanzania. Nubians are in South Africa, in Nigeria, all over Africa. But the real origin of the Nubians around the Nuba Mountain, Egypt, Northern Sudan, Egypt, Libya, around that area.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, let me just take you to the first song. There's this Abaka Ching Ching. What is this Abaka Ching Ching? This is actually a phrase you're repeating so many times in this song called Binaya.
When the chorus came up, when I wrote this song, as I told you, this is a song, as I was writing this song, the Abaka Ching Ching bird came into my mind. At the same time, my great friend Arua was also in my mind. And I would close my eyes and just imagine and just laugh off. And I was like, and the rhymes came in. Actually, most of these verses, I wrote it when I was aboard my bus, that is Mashkul, when I was actually heading to Kampala and, of course, back to Stone City in Zinza, the source of the Nile. So, like, in about, 4 days, the song was done. So, Abaka Ching Ching is, there is this beautiful bird. This bird is so lovely. This bird is loved by all birds.
Mm.
You know, I don't know how you call it in your language, but the Abaka Ching Ching bird, it's a bird that has so much love.
Mm-hmm.
It's a bird like, yani yondege, kila ndege inaipenda. Nae mwenyewe pia, iyo Abaka Ching Ching pia, it loves any other bird. So, I don't know how really to
I think you're not telling the whole story.
But at least you have to take it from there that Abaka Ching Ching eats the love. So when it reflects to the song, Binianubi, Dugana Maching Ching. So I'm telling the Binianubi to give me that love, the love that Abaka Ching Ching has.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that lovely. But then we had different hip hop groups in Uganda and hip hop organizations in Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
So before that, you know, there was a lot of confusion going on in Uganda by then. They had we had a Uganda Hip Hop Foundation, but then the foundation was not actually embracing every MC together, because, you know, just like the way in any other place there are hip hop wars and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, no, guys, we have to resolve this. And, you know, so as a leader, I sat down Of my group, because by then I had a group that was called the Nubians.
And was it related with the Nubians with the attitude based in Nairobi?
No. Actually, the Nubians with attitude inspired me so much, because, you know, by the time when I was living in Kibera, number 9, Motherland, Kibich,
can you remember their songs?
Yeah, Nabado.
Nimbombi toto na yusu, Nabado.
Nabado. Oh my God, one of the biggest fans, all five, man. So basically, the Nubians with attitude, but then the Nubians here, we had not only MCs rapping in the Nubian language, but we had so many other things. We had poets, we had break dancers, we had graffiti artists, and we had guys rapping in Luo, in guys rapping in Luganda, guys rapping in Runyankole. So it was a fusion of so many things together. And then after the Arise Hip Hop Uganda, I was like, now guys, at least I'm glad we've resolved something. So what should we do now? We're like, now, can we focus on something that is even more significant? Then forth came Arise Hip Hop Uganda that we had to actually push for about a year. Then later on, we're like, no. I sat down. Then the vision of Bonfire came to me. That was actually when I'd actually left Mombasa, because I was in Mombasa like for 9 months, where I actually worked at the port. The violence of 2007 to 2008 found me actually working at the port. Then later on, around mid-2008, I had to go back to my country. That's go back to Uganda. And started Bonfire, the Bonfire movement.
Okay. So far, when you're talking about this movement, what are some of the projects that you've done that you think, wow, when I look back, I've done a great thing?
Well, first of all, to begin with one thing that maybe I would like to tell our dear listeners. Somebody might ask, what is Bonfire Uganda? Well, Bonfire Uganda is a youth-led organization that uses creative and performing arts for positive social change and development. And my biggest actual vision for starting this organization, I wanted it to be one of the strongest non-profit organization that actually would creatively change young people, for them to have a positive life and move on, and to empower them, you know, through poetry, through dance, through the hip-hop culture. Because, you know, the thing is, where there is hip-hop, there are always young people. And another thing that I focused on so much was the core values of Bonfire. And the biggest of all was so many young people today have lost their moral integrity, so we had to actually revive that. And I'm glad that through the Bonfire nights that we had, it really helped them so much, and also developed their talent, because where there is talent, a young man and a young woman will always have hope. And also culture being the core foundation of our lives. And you know, when you look at Uganda is built on a very strong culture. But now the influence of the Western culture had actually started dissolving some parts of the culture. You'd find that not a lot of young people would now still embrace poetry, things to do with riddles in their languages. So we're like, no, would like this to come back and push it even more strongly. So through the Bonfire Nights, that happened. And then the equality part of it. Because, you know, in Uganda, we have over 1 million refugees. You know, so we're like, if we have a refugee artist come, can't we also have his fire and my fire and our fire together, then together with the Bonfire? Bonfire is Mambo ya Moto na Nini. It's about you and me. It's about Gerald Orumbi and General Ugly. It's about the different brothers coming up together and building a Bonfire. So I'm glad at least we managed to do that and we managed to move on. Yeah.
Okay, I think now we need to have a short break. We come back to Kenya. We listen to one song by King's colleague Ramdi Kina and Viviana. The song is called Karma. When we come back, we'll be speaking to our guest today. He's called Ugly, all the way from Uganda.
Aina ile statinga kiza itabidi mekama mapema juu staki kitu lost kwangu poa.
Aina mbio brazi, pamoja.
Yonde tena. Yes, yo energy sawa. King's colleague hapa, au sio? Maybe na play safe.
whatever places. Napenda blessings, cause it make sense. Naweza mengi, na jenga pengi. Enjoyment plenty, fulfillment maybe. Niweza blend fit, lazima succeed. Shikisha benefit, team is a practice. Vile na submit, no same topic. I mean, ni chances na best fit classics. Ka leo, niko higher na sight. Ha, bado leo, hizo light and bright. Ha, naweza fly hood, vile na run through. Nicheze round two, bado me smiles juu. Hizo hazifanyi kagi zu balance life. Cheka na fantasy, unezata I high five. Jenga mangevye zone, maybe ni pendo zone. Ijaze new trends, the happiness, ziwe more.
Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Na balance, na final, ni highlights alone. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Na balance, na final, ni highlights alone.
Acrobat instincts, mina balance. Stare kam kidi, mina balance. Nina taki ama pedi. Minda balance, na balance. My high grade, na high then na ripe yani. Ni we high, ni feeling as a hug heavens yani. Same chill mode, new connect na my cheese in dani. Iwe cubing, clubbing, atakani, cypher kani. Be freestyle funny, bila serious planning. Moment ka, he's as a pity, bila selfie. Reason he's a guitar, ziko, sensible na sensi. Kani coast to seme, na sunbust, na stunners. Refreshment cold enough, kuongeza start stammers. Banga izi a cocktail, stare piti apa. Vest in a speak up, da, ni proper, so tolerize situation. Kila kitu bahali yake, glasses juu, yeah, cheers and say hey.
Bado hii hindo life mina balance. Bado hii hindo life mina balance. Bado hii hindo life mina balance. Na balance na final on the highlights of love. Bado hii hindo life mina balance. Bado hii hindo life mina balance. Bado hii hindo life mina balance. Na balance na final on the highlights of love.
From classes pia kuna movies pia, socializing here, kuna njoti skia, si lazima nia, but ineza bamba dia,
na balance na final ni highlights alone.
Si bambi haso, malipo nazo, safiri ngambo, ni kufanya mambo, studio jumbos, sweetness nayo,
na balance na final ni highlights alone.
Na holiday life, you were simply dumb, hizo convert crew neza ita farm, zaidi ya dish na shiba, stare na cram light,
na balance na final ni highlights alone.
Chizea ligi, yo janja maybe. Uram stress free, lazima happy. Soma dibaji, kunazo mengi.
Na balance, na final, ni highlights alone. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Na balance, na final, ni highlights alone. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Bado hii hindo life, mina balance. Na balance, na final, ni highlights alone.
Kana kemba kembe ile Habenga dabatu wafu Habatu jaku Gana uhakuka basuwa kumoyo.
From the bottom of my heart Tumewa miss Rohoni moyoni. From the bottom of my heart
Tunawa miss, rohoni moyoni. Tunawa miss. Kifoni nini sometime, nina babu, kaka na dada, marafiki na maadui. Kifoni nini mbona haina huruma, hata kidogo kaskazini, kusini, mashariki, magharibi. Ina tumaliza, ina tutenganisha na kuliva big space behind that nobody can fill, nobody can replace. Na deep inside, ina feel pain, where ina feel pain, sote tuna feel pain. The good days, the bad days, sasa ni past tense. Lakini, ninajua mko heaven, na smile on us. Mki tuish, only the best in our lives, cause life goes on. Acha kulia dada, acha kulia kaka, acha kulia.
From the bottom of my heart,
Rohoni moyoni.
From the bottom of my heart,
Rohoni moyoni.
Tunawa misi mtu file kuimebetuwa yendanga. Mtu leke ile nsisi wono ula mtu wechanga. Kuse mama tewe yande kawo ya jebu chaira. Nako igana wa mna ulanga zetu kawira. Yasobile vyantu kwa kuna kutisula kukuna ye.
Tikap na dolo tikaria diabu sani songa wa chize neidusa. Sasira na baba na batwe vale singa basira buyabi. Akaba kugama tenga talina na simbi. Mupere mbi eta wate na subi. Ibobe kustwiti kumbala zanga bala jana. Ayi mukama kwena nyini kwa tisaka sana. Sabile meo chaba bapo jumu zewe jisana. Chitaro ino, chitaro ino.
From the bottom of my heart, 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 from the bottom of my heart.
Nina kwa chupepa na pain, create evas, he pain. Ili nitowe his stress na strain. Dear God, moyoni nina umo sana. Furaha misine nina usulika sana, nina nusulika sana. Kwani kile nikibiga picha jekani. Ina kan fiba kan why. Mahabate ina kan ketir. Kan tekin lakini the day yulipodedi. Dunia taija deiga. Chap abida kulana minsu rasla ifidufu tight. Kom tai abi du sete tu anagikore kwa sababu jipense inajua. I can never bring you back. Oh, I can't make your soul rest in peace.
Amen. From the bottom of my heart, from the bottom of my heart,
Marehemu Babu Kenyatta Mzee Odinga Odinga Dedan Kimathi Mau Mau Mwalimu Julius Nyerere Baba wa Taifa Dr. Milton Obote Tito Okello Dr. John Garang Malcolm X Babu Wangu Field Marshal Amin Dada Mobutu Sese Mzee Kabila Patrice Lumumba Martin Luther King Kwame Nkrumah na wote waliotuacha Mola Lazi Roho Zenu Manipema.
Tunawamiss, that's all from General Ugly Emcee, grandson of the late Amin Dada, or as he would introduce himself, Field Marshal KBC. yeah, GTV, and everything, man.
Yeah,
sampling Benny Siegel there. I can feel it in the air.
Yeah, actually, we sat down, and that was 2009. And
where did you sample him? Then,
no, what happened is we wrote to these guys, we sent to them an email. I sent them an email personally. And said, guys, listen, I feel this track and there is something I'd like to do it, to do this track with. And they asked me, is it for commercial or non-profit? I was like, no, I'm doing a, it's non-profit and I'm making a, I want to do a tribute to my late grandfather. And, you know, in the mail, I had to clearly explain to them that this is, I'm doing a tribute to my late grandfather.
Nice.
And they really appreciate it. Said, yeah, you go ahead, do it.
Who are the guys, the record label, which was?
This is Rockefeller? Yeah, this is their managers and stuff. I wrote to them and it was okay. They're all good with it.
Okay,
After producing the song, did you send?
Yeah, you sent. It's actually all online.
Yeah, so you sent this song to them.
Yeah,
you did request for it.
Yeah, of course you have to, because you have to because you know, for copyright issues, you have to really also consent and to show respect, because they created this. Because this actually, when I listened to this track, it spoke to me and I was like, no, I'm not going to do any other thing.
And just, sorry to interfere, but
yes.
Maybe one thing that maybe this brings into art of sampling.
Yes.
Back in Kenya when we land on these hot tracks, you know, from other MCs.
Mm.
Do you believe that's what really happens, Jared? No? What he did is basically professional.
Professional. Yeah.
What should happen, right?
Let me not speak on behalf of MCs because one time.
But this is what should be happening.
I expect this what should be happening. So one time they'll come to the studio and I think you'll ask them that question.
For real. Yes, back to General Ugly Emcee.
Yes.
And in the trail of thoughts of this song, and you sat down and wrote this song that you call.
Yeah, I called it Tunawamiss.
Tunawamiss.
You know, in the first verse, I asked myself something that was so deep. Because remember, I lost my father when I was very young, when I was actually still a baby. And
So when I was writing this verse, I looked at so many things, you know, people dying and stuff. So when you listen, let me just take you back to the first verse where I say, Kifo ni nini sometime ni najuliza, imemuwa baba, imemuwa mama, kaka na dada. Basically, I'm trying to look at that very part. What is kifo? No. Because one day, you and me, even us who are now in the studio and even our dear listeners, will have to say bye-bye to this beautiful world and go to the afterlife.
Yes.
So, in the question, when you listen to this song, it's not just actually a song. It's a song with so many questions. Like even in the last verse, where I say, Nina kwachu pepa na pain kuwrite he verse, he pain, ili nitowe his stress na strain. So I'm not just, it's actually this song is beyond rap. I'm not just rapping or feeling the flow. I'm speaking my heart out. And that's when I had to feature one of the Bonfire soldiers, and that is none other than Jango the Man Eater, mm-hmm. all the way from Busoga region.
Mm-hmm.
That is another kingdom. You know, in Uganda, we have kingdoms.
Yes.
So I chose this language, the Lusoga language, because the way he would rap and the way he would brought his words out,
mm-hmm.
it really matched with the way I wanted it. And in this verse, actually, he's also looking at what death is. You know, you leave children behind, you leave everything behind.
Could it be the saddest song you ever wrote?
Yeah, it is. The saddest ever.
Okay, I think I'm
more sad.
Okay, let me take you back. I mean, let's talk about Ugandan hip-hop and the movement. I mean, earlier you said... the movement is actually growing and so on. You also talked about national theater and why it's important for to remain as a center to develop art in the country and, you know, for posterity.
Yes.
How's the hip-hop ground in Uganda? I mean, tell us one of the, not big cuts, I'm not talking about big or small cuts, let's talk about how is it? I mean, what are the landmarks, what are the areas that you guys are doing better than us, as an observer also?
Yeah, because actually, one thing, talking about cuts, actually I loved it when you brought the word cuts. Because be it a small or a big cut, a cut is a cut. Because as long as it meows. So in Uganda, I'm actually so happy, you know, that the element, you know, hip-hop has so many elements. The element of breakdancing in Uganda today has significantly changed the face of Ugandan hip-hop. Actually, I give credits to Abrahams of Breakdance Project Uganda, Abdul of Batalo East, and of course Tabo Dance Flow and all the team, Abdul Philip, and also Galaxy Dance Project that has come up, Chuka Youth Outreach, Talanta Youth Movement, you know, Street Dance Force, Dream House Uganda, all the way from Bale. And all these movements, you know, in Uganda we have movements, like the different groups that are trying to push this together. And the element of poetry in Uganda has actually grown so much that when it comes to poetry, because, you know, to me, I would define actually poetry as best words arranged in the best order. So the element of poetry in Uganda is so much in order that we even have a poetry festival. Talk of the BN Poetry Festival. Talk of groups like Lantern Meet of Poets, talk of Poetry Shine, talk of Bonfire Poets, you know, talk of the Kelele Poets who meet at Makere every Thursday, you know, every first Thursday. So you find the movement of poetry in Uganda is really, really strong. And unlike in Kenya, where when you look at the element of DJing is very big, DJs in Kenya are really, really on top. When it comes to the element of graffiti in Kenya, actually respect to that. Graffiti artists in Kenya are really, really on point. All over East Africa, actually. Maybe I should say East and Central Africa. In Kenya, there is graffiti. Graffiti artists in Kenya are really, really serious. Where the battle is now is, where do we get the realest MCs? Do we get them in Kenya? Do we get them in Uganda?
Uh-huh.
Do we get them in Tanzania?
Uh-huh.
So maybe that one will actually account. In Uganda is so much in order that we even have a poetry festival. Talk of the BN Poetry Festival. Talk of groups like Lantern Meet of Poets. Talk of Poetry Shine. Talk of Bonfire Poets. You know, talk of the Kelele poets who meet at Makere every Thursday, you know, every first Thursday. So you find the movement of poetry in Uganda is really, really strong. And unlike in Kenya, where when you look at the element of DJing is very big, DJs in Kenya really, really on top. When it comes to the element of graffiti in Kenya, actually respect to that. Graffiti artists in Kenya really, really on point. All over East Africa, actually. Maybe I should say East and Central Africa. In Kenya, there is graffiti. Graffiti artists in Kenya are really, really serious. Where the battle is now is, where do we get the realest MCs? Do we get them in Kenya? Do we get them in Uganda? Uh-huh. Do we get them in Tanzania? Uh-huh. So maybe that one will actually together called I Am Hip Hop.
Yes.
And with the I Am Hip Hop live advocacy, it will, mm-hmm. it will only stop in Uganda, because in Uganda we have a band, the Bonfire Band, and actually on with the Bonfire Band, we want to redefine hip hop, whereby we're not just looking at the element of DJing and getting MCs just rapping on the beat and then CDs and stuff. We want it to be 100% live.
Mm-hmm.
Can we get imagine Rhymes Intellectual strumming a guitar,
mm-hmm.
imagine Small Lethal playing a piano, imagine Octopizzo playing a bass guitar and rapping on it, and it's really serious and it's actually
okay,
like,
so which instrument do you play?
I play drums.
You play
I
drums.
Play the African drums.
African drums.
I play them. Because when I play the African drums, it actually speaks to me.
But do you think when you say African drums, is the easiest way out? I mean, no. How to play these drums.
Gerald. When you talk of the African drums, it's how do you play it? It's not about just getting the drums and hitting it. No. The drums have to talk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so actually I play the African drums and I make them to talk, uh-huh. they speak to me.
Okay, listeners, yeah. if you're joining us now, today we're actually talking to General Ugly Emcee all the way from Uganda. If you want to be part of this show today, we are actually opening our lines. You can call us on 0736-538-431. You can call us on 0736-538-431. You can also call us on 0725-281-428. You can call us on 0725-281-428. Remember, you can ask any question because, you know, we're not the only ones with questions, you know, in life. So,
and Jerry, actually, I've moved with some stuff from Uganda.
Uh-huh.
So actually, whoever calls has to get something. As long as if you put your contribution.
Generally, in Jared, man.
Yeah. So,
this
yeah.
way to get the Mutasari or Habari. Do you know what it is?
It's the news.
Yeah?
The news, I guess.
No, Mukhtasari.
Mukhtasari.
Yeah,
it's, the news in brief.
Yes, very good. You're lying.
Yes, but imagine, news in brief at midnight or?
Yes, at midnight.
At midnight.
They will be back with, people want to ask questions. My dad says they're not the only ones who have questions.
This is the news summary with me, Richard Munga.